Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good weekend, all. Ira Epstein with your weekend edition of your Metals Market Report. And this is for Friday, the 9th of February, 2018. We're just getting on to about 1:50 in the afternoon. It's so much snow in Chicago, I know I'm going home early. It's a lot of shoveling. We're going to get upwards of 12 inches in the city, believe it or not. All right. In the gold, you've tried a bunch of rallies, and even with the stock market down this much, you're not bouncing away. Now, as you all know, I showed last week price counts, and in fact, if you get our price count information, we put out another one today that showed that the 1309 level did hold the gold on its first break, but you might be breaking down yet to the 1290s before it's said and done. Today was an interesting day. At the lows of the day today, when the stock market was breaking, you were barely able to get gold higher on the day. Not a good sign for it because people aren't running to it as the safe haven. They've run to the Japanese yen. They ran to the bonds and the notes. And these have sold off pretty good from the day's highs because the stock market at its lows was giving a bid maybe 10 minutes ago. So it's 150 now. These markets started going positive. Now they're starting to roll again. It's back and forth crazy action. The energy markets, I took a look at the crude from high to low. You've dropped 13%. So you're in a long-term correction, not necessarily a bear market from its new highs, but that correction phase. If you use the Dow theory, you have to drop 20% to do that. We'll see if that happens. When I look at gold on a monthly chart, what excites me on the chart is all this sideways action. If I'm wrong, I'll let you know because you'll be breaking out to the downside. More times than not, when volatility comes out of a market and you get sideways action, the markets quietly tend to break out to the upside. Now, gold is fighting a battle on this chart at the 100-month moving average in green and the upper Bollinger Band. Momentum hasn't turned down, but it's not pointing higher. It's just sort of drifting sideways right now, which sort of fits in with what's going on. I mentioned that 1296 level to you, and actually the 1290s I said a moment ago, because if you look at the weekly area chart of closes, you peaked at 1352, and that's on a close. Now, do remember, you went up $107 close to close from the low to the high, and you're in a corrective stage right now. You've given back roughly $38 of that rally at this point in time. So you're in the neighborhood, if you even look at Fibonacci retracements, of about a third. You could go to 50%, which sort of puts into play this 1290 area if the market wants to come down there. As we take a look at just a chart, a weekly chart with nothing on it at all, I can argue also maybe there's a gap in here this market wants to fill, and I don't forget those. Gaps on charts have a tendency to get filled, and if we come back, and we could, you can see that if I'm right, the high right here is 1276.30, and the low was 1281.80. You should, on your charts, what I sometimes do is circle them for myself, or I'll remember them. It depends, you know, which way you go. Because I'm a commodity broker, I remember a lot of things, and just one of the ways that you do it. So we're in a small corrective zone. You can see how the market has the lower low and the swing line, the higher high. That's not a trend. If you put the moving averages on it, I can make a pretty good argument that if the momentum is going to break down, the 18-week moving average is interesting. And, of course, the 100-week becomes super interesting. I don't know if you're going to get to the 200-week, this gray line all the way down there. You first got to get under the 18. So that seems to be the magnet that the prices want to come down to. The market failed on this rally at the upper Bollinger Bands. It went there, it spent 2 weeks over, couldn't push itself out, momentum turned up, and then on the momentum, it's now down. So let me put it to you real simply. On the weekly chart, momentum is down. The bias is up because you're over the 18-week, average of closes, but you're not trending. If you define a trend as higher highs and higher lows for an uptrend, you don't have that. If you define it as a downtrend, lower highs, lower lows, you don't have that either. So you have nothing there. You got a market that's drifting. When we come into the GLD ETF, the momentum's pointing down. It's the same pattern as futures. Lower low, higher high, ran into its resistance here. First technical support, the 123 level. The gold miners are not acting good. They are still pointing to the downside, as you can see, 2144. Often, the word is not always, often, the miners seem to pick up before the market picks up. It's not doing it. If anything, it's still pointing down and futures are stalling out. This market's momentum is down, 2144, the next downside target. Silver market. Silver had a miserable failure right here, the week of January 26th. It had had an outside week up. If you take out the low of an outside week up, often I look for the closest of a key moving average. Unfortunately, they're all above us, or the lower Bollinger Band. That lower Bollinger Band is very much in play right now as momentum is still pointing down. So at this point, at least, I can say that I'm not seeing gold or silver trying to pick up in any manner. Then we get to the copper market. It's called Dr. Copper because it's often a bellwether for world economies. Now, I'm wondering, and this is all that it is, a wonder, as the U.S. stock market has tanked into a correction phase, we're also watching, be it the Nikkei, be it the Chinese markets, be it European stock markets, everything's pulling back with it. Is that scaring the copper? Could be. Could be that the market's fearful that maybe that's a revaluation. People get nervous. They don't invest. They don't buy. You don't know what the thinking is. But this market's in a downtrend, at least on the weekly chart. You got clear-cut lower highs, lower lows, momentum down, bias down. 297.95 seems to be a potential target on the lower Bollinger Band. In the platinum market, you have no trend. Unlike the copper, you've got a lower low, a higher high that again failed at that upper Bollinger Band. And so far, the 100-week average didn't support the market. It looks like it's going to be under it on the close. So the next stopping spot, if the market wants to go there, and with momentum pointing down, there's reasons to think that could be the 948 level, roughly that 18-week moving average of closes. The palladium market, which had one of these vertical price rises, and it really began in September. Yeah, September of last year. It culminated in January, began correcting, and this was the week of February 2nd, and now you can see where you're headed, and it looks as though if the market wants to go to the Bollinger Band, that support's going to be closer to 932 level. Dollar index turned back up, but hasn't broken out of its downtrend. It still has a clean pattern of lower highs, lower lows. Momentum trying to come out of that over where it was bearish and flatten itself out. And I think it's done that. So now the question is, do we get much more of a rally in that? And that's what you have to look at as you see all this. You can see how the swings are in the stock market from when I began this to where you're at right now. But you haven't moved much in the metal markets at all. So we'll see if the stocks can finish the week off with a bit of short covering. Wouldn't surprise me, being down 13%. Some people that are short might want to take money off the table. But we'll be writing about this and so many other subjects, and we do it on the weekend too. So if you like to start your trading, as so many people do, and you come in on a Sunday night and you want to know what is there to read, well, generally they're rehashed stories, not with us. Our crew is writing throughout the weekend. We start you off especially for the grains and the meats, and then I'm writing about the financial markets for my subscribers. They have it by Sunday night. They've got everything in their hands. We cover all these different subjects, and no, you don't have to try them all. You can try the ones you want. We allow you to pick and choose if you haven't tried them before. If you have and you haven't opened up an account with us, not available to you. If you haven't tried it, why not take a look at what a commodity firm writes for its commodity customers? And yes, we talk hedging, option strategies, cash strategies in these markets. You might want to take a good look. How do you get access to it? It's really simple. You can either call my staff at 866-973-2077. You can go online. Just go to our website. You'll see the front page. It's a carousel. Choose any of the offers. The forms will come up. Choose what you want. Click up here if you're watching me on YouTube, or underneath us on many websites. It says click here for Ira's free information. I'm Ira Epstein from a snowy Chicago. I will see you all Monday, I hope. You have a great weekend.